There are two people joining us, so we're going to start in just a moment, but we're going to begin on our backs today. So find a nice comfortable spot on your back. If you need to safeguard the low back for any reason, keep the knees bent while you're on your spine, or you can keep the soles of the feet together, butterfly your legs open in a reclined butterfly position if that feels good. I just want to make sure that the distance here is okay. Perfect. So yes, like I said, we can lay flat on our back, legs long, knees can be bent to release the natural curvature of the spine, or if you're feeling like opening up the hips today, you can begin with the soles of your feet together, knees dropping down. And that will create that natural curve in the spine at the low back. So if that's far too much for the lumbar spine, then please, please, please place your feet flat. If you have the opportunity to allow the exhales to travel out of your mouth, maybe even in somewhat of an exasperated way, making sound as you exhale, giving space for the breath to not only take up room in your body, but also take up sound within your space. Like, des fois, c'est tellement important de soupirer. De relâcher nos respirations. Des fois, on respire juste un moitié de notre capacité. Notice if you're only breathing with the top half of your lungs. And if you are, allow those breaths to really start to transcend towards the middle and towards the base of the lungs so that you feel the breath originating or ending in the belly, depending on where it is that you are in the breath. If you're exhaling, you want to feel it end there. If you are inhaling, feel it start in the belly and start rising all the way through the body. As you know, we're here for a 60-minute vinyasa, so we will be moving, we will be breathing, we will be flowing, but for right now, our intention is to bring consciousness and awareness to the way that the breath is traveling within the body. And as you feel your breaths, notice the point of contact, each point of contact of your body with the floor, with the mat, with the earth, whether it's the back of your skull, your shoulder blades, your low back. If your feet are planted, notice how the entire foot feels. If your legs are extended, notice the way that the back of your heels feel on the floor. And with your next exhale, I want you to imagine giving up the entire energy of gravity. Imagine that you were just completely releasing yourself into the earth and allowing for it to hold you up here. Today, we are focusing on support. Le support de nos corps, le support de nos tapis, le support de notre pratique, le support de nos respirations, de notre énergie. So even though this is an individual solo practice, think of all the supporting elements that become a part of it. S'il y a des parties qui vous supportez pas, peut-être des pensées, essayez de les respirer hors de vos corps. So if you're noticing those monkey brain pattern thoughts starting to come in, if that's not supportive to the next 60 minutes of your movement and of your breath, I invite you to take this time to use your exhales to relinquish them and to give up space for the support that is there for you to be present. This creates trust within the body. This creates a foundation so that self-love can be built on there. Once we know that we can support ourselves through energy, through breath, through intention, and ultimately through this practice. Once you've completed your next exhale, take your time, no rush. Bring your knees into your chest one at a time. Wrap your arms around your legs. Give yourself a really nice squeeze as you rock side to side. And remember that at the end of the day, you are always your biggest fan, your biggest support system. You are with you 100% of the time. Release your arms from around your legs. On trouve un étirement du corps complet. Fait extension avec les deux jambes et les bras. Let your feet come down onto the mat. Reach your fingertips all the way up. On trouve beaucoup de longueur pendant l'inspiration. So breathe in and reach. Get as long as you possibly can. Et on expire par la bouche, puis on relâche les bras et les jambes. So just bring your elbows and your feet to flop open. Two more times. Engaging on the breath in. And releasing on the breath out. Last one. Breathe in. Reach. And really let it out. Don't be shy. Bringing your arms by your side. Bringing your knees into your chest. Breathe in. And bring the legs up. Breathe out. Take a deep breath in here. And lowering the legs down halfway. Exhale. Breathe in, come back up with the legs. Exhale, bringing them down to hover. So your heels are about 3 to 6 inches off the floor. Bend into your knees, bring the legs up, breathe in, on inspire. Et on descend les jambes, un moitié expiration. Keep the back glued to the mat, on inspire, encore les talons vers le ciel, bring your legs back up. Expiration, on descend les jambes presque complètement, not all the way. Two more times. Bend and lift. Breathe in. Exhale, halfway lower. Good. Breathe in, come back up. Exhale to hover. Keep the low back onto the mat. Breathe in. Bend and extend. Exhale, halfway lower. Encore les talons vers le ciel. On inspire. Expiration, on descend et on garde ici. Hold your heels up off the floor for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring your knees into your chest. Exhale and rock side to side. Ici, on ouvre les bras comme un lettre T. Open your arms up like a letter T. Palms are facing the floor. Keep your knees bent. So notice when your knees are into your body, if you lift up your shins, your calves about halfway to keep this 90 degrees. Notice how close my knees, you can take a peek if you can see. If you can't, notice if your knees are a lot closer to your body than your hips are. You want to push your knees away to start to create that ab activation. Yes, beautiful. Arms are by the sides, palms are facing down. We always breathe in at center. And then drop your legs over to the left side. Exhale, keep both shoulders glued onto the mat the entire time. On inspire, on revient au milieu. Et expiration, côté droit. Right side, drop. Toujours un contact avec les deux épaules sur le tapis. On inspire, au milieu, come back to center. Left side, lower, exhale. Breathe in, come back to center. Keep those shoulders contact. Exhale, over to the right. One more time, each side. Breathe in, au milieu. Côté gauche, on expire. Back to center, breathe in. And exhale over to the right. Inhale, come back to center and wrap your arms around your legs. Give yourself a nice squeeze. From here, we're going to find boat pose, position de bateau. Extension dans les jambes, les mains en arrière de nos jambes. Good. Hands are behind the knees. Pick up the head, neck, and shoulders. Begin to rock and roll the length of your spine. This is a great time to give yourself a little massage. And then create enough momentum to find that connection with the sits bones. Yes. Hands are here. We use, on utilise les mains toujours. Use your hands to pull up your heart. Beaucoup de fierté dans la poitrine. Et on descend les épaules. On reste ici pour trois. Deux. Soft facial features for one. Begin to soften the spine, so round into the back, and we're gonna rock and roll again one or two times, and we're going to create enough momentum to come back into boat for a second cycle. Option is to keep your hands here, or you can challenge yourselves by floating your arms by the sides of the legs for three. Two more, pride in the chest. Maybe for the last breath, if you really want to challenge yourself, extend the legs. Take a deep breath in, bring your hands back behind your knees, all that pride in the chest, and then drop your legs, soles of the feet together, let your knees fall open. So we're in this kind of butterfly, and I just want you to plop the body down in between the legs. Fait qu'on descend le torse entre les jambes, le front vers les pieds, très passif. Keep your chin tucked in towards your chest. Slowly roll yourself up. Et on utilise les mains pour guider les jambes ensemble. Use your hands to guide your legs together. Swing the legs around the body to find your tabletop pose. So our hands are underneath our shoulders. Our knees are underneath our hips. Dropping the belly on the inhale, opening up the chest plate, lifting up the chin, look up. And exhale, round into the spine, connect with your cat pose, and drop the head. On inspire, on descend le ventre, on ouvre la poitrine entre les bras, on garde vers le ciel, push the floor away from you at this time. And then exhale, connect the fingertips to the floor as you round into the back, push the pelvis forward towards your arms. One last time, breath in with intention. Drop the belly slowly, feel that extension in the skin, in the organs, in the bones, in the muscles. Exhale and round. Finding a flat back, neutral spine here. Walk your right hand over to the center of the mat, reaching your left arm up to the sky. Breathe in and exhale, feed the needle. So right through, thread it through. And extend now your right arm all the way out. Keep your hips right above your knees and reaching that left arm out through that space. Take two. Continuing to pull that shoulder back into its socket, feeling that opening in the shoulder girdle. Last breath. Main droit devant le visage, right hand in front of the face. Press and lift all the way back up. Exhale and come down. Même chose l'autre côté. Main gauche maintenant au milieu. Main droite lève. Expiration, on met la main droite entre le trou ici. Walk, 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 walk that arm forward. Make sure that the weight in between your knees is even. Fait qu'on veut égaler nos poids entre les deux genoux. One more breath here. Bringing your left hand just in front of your face. Again, press and lift all the way up. Breathe in. Exhale and come back down. So the hands again are underneath the shoulders. Knees stay exactly where they were. Curl into the toes, finding your floating tabletop. So lift up your knees about 3 inches off the floor, looking towards the top of your mat always, taking three. Last one. Keeping your knees off the floor, open up your legs slightly, press your hips back so you're kind of in this floating child's pose almost. And then exhale, send your hips up high, downward facing dog. Walk it out, pedal it out, extend the muscles behind the legs. There's a very good chance this is your first down dog of the day, so feel it out. On veut toujours pousser les 10 doigts dans le tapis. Plutôt la pouce puis le doigt index. So index finger and thumb are really, really pressing into the mat as much as possible. Take one last breath here. Good. Looking up towards your hands, taking those little baby steps up towards your wrists. On trouve un demi-remonté, halfway lift, breath in. And bringing the weight into the toes as you fold over, exhale, make it really nice and passive. On va faire ça un autre deux fois. Try to get your back as flat as possible. Literally, imagine a family of four being able to eat right off of your back. Like it's a table. And then exhale and fold. Last one. Flat back. Beaucoup de longueur en arrière du cou. On garde vers le haut du tapis. And open the mouth. Really let it go. Exhale. Take one here. Let your arms hang heavily in front of your body as you roll your way up, stacking your vertebra all the way to the top, circling your arms with you as you get there. Les mains en prière, expiration devant le cœur. If you're not already towards the top of your mat, step up a little bit closer, breathe in, arms up. Maybe you find a micro bend in the back and then hinge at the hips, exhale and fold. Breathe in to find your halfway lift. And again, just fold here, exhale. That's our half sun salutation. Breathe in, arms come up. And exhale, hands to heart center. Good. Again, inhale, arms to rise. Maybe you find that back bend at the top of your inhale and then exhale, hinge and fold. On trouve notre demi-remontée, halfway lift. Expiration, position de planche, plank pose. We're gonna hold here, breathe in, and hold here, exhale. Shift the body weight forward so your shoulders pass your wrists, drop your knees and wrap those elbows. Exhale, control your lower, modify chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra, lift and engage. Squeeze the elbows to your midline. Exhale and drop it back down. Find your plank pose, position de planche, on inspire. Chien à tête inversé, down dog, exhale. Take a breath in and exhale. Les deux pieds ensemble, right leg to rise, breathe in. Step the foot through the hands and drop down the back knee. Breathe in, reach the arms up. Exhale and sink into this lowering. So notice how much I'm dropping my hips. You can either choose to stay here or for two breaths, bring the arms back so the thumbs are pointing behind you. Les pouces vers l'arrière de vous. Toujours de la fierté dans la poitrine. And you're thinking about your belly here. Ask yourself, are you just dumping your belly forward or are you thinking about lifting your belly button up and back with you? Last breath. If you were in that back bend, come back up, breathe in. Exhale, bring your hands down. Curl the back toes, lift the back leg, step back and hold your plank, exhale. Take a breath in. Send your hips up high, downward dog. Breathe out. Même chose, l'autre côté. Left leg up. And send that foot forward. Exhale, drop the back knee right away. Sweep the arms up. For this first breath, just drop the shoulders, stay in the middle, and really focus on your legs. We have two more breaths here. Breathe in. Maybe you start to send those fingertips back. Last one. Come back up to center, breathe in. Exhale, drop the hands down. Curl the back toes, position de planche. And hold here. This time, drop the knees, wrap the elbows, and next exhale, control your lower down. Baby cobra, breathe in, lift, and exhale, drop. Position de planche, again, plank pose, breathe in. Exhale, hips up high, downward dog. Take two here and come back to that intention, l'intention de support. Ici, maintenant, dans le chien à tête inversée, c'est nos mains, puis nos pieds qui nous supportent. But outside of your physical body, what is supporting you right now? Are your thoughts supportive? Is your breath supportive? Is the energy and intention behind each movement supportive? Here, I'm going to invite you to lift the heels, bend the knees, step, step, or gently float to your hands, halfway lift. Et puis on plonge ici, expiration. Inhale to rise. Hands to heart center, exhale. Bring the big toes to touch, sliver of space behind the heels, chair pose. Bend into the knees, sweep back and up, breathe in. And sink into your chair, exhale. Breathe in, lift almost completely, keep a micro bend in the knees. And then just as you reach the top, exhale, sink back down. Two more times, inhale, lift, and then sink. One last time, lift, squeeze those legs together, and then sink. Hands to heart center gives us the breath in, proud chest, and then exhale, we fold down. On ouvre les pieds à distance de nos hanches, feet are hips with distance, halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, step into your plank pose and find chaturanga modified or not, this is your choice. Back bend, baby cobra, or upward dog, lift. Good, exhale, hips up high. Right away, right leg rises, breathe in. Step the foot through to find a high lunge. So now we're lifting up, keeping that back leg engaged. Exhale and twist over to the right side. Good, breathe in, come back to center. Exhale, twist over to the left. Au milieu, on inspire. Tout en expiration, position de planche, chaturanga, exhale. Upward dog or baby cobra. Downward dog, exhale. Génial, on prend une inspiration. Et on ouvre la bouche, puis on expire. Come high to the toes, bend the knees, step. Walk or gently float to your hands, halfway lift. Et on plonge, puis on expire. Inhale to rise. Hands to heart center, exhale. Take a deep breath in and out. This time for our second cycle of chair, we're going to keep our feet about hips width distance. So bend into your knees. Your big toes are not touching now, so leave some space. Good, bend into the knees, sweep your arms back. And up, breathe in, exhale and sink. Ce moment ici, je veux être sûre qu'on peut voir les orteils. Look down, see if you can see your toes. Then we're going to interlace the fingers and push the palms away from the body. Option here is to lower your head down, looking towards the top of your mat. Second option is we can begin to lift up the heels and start to send the pelvis forward by creating a little bit more challenge and a little bit more balance. If this is too much for you, keep the feet on the floor. We're still engaging the abdominals and the back. We're gonna hold for one more. If your heels are lifted, drop them down, breathe in, rise all the way up, and swan dive over the legs. On ouvre les bras, puis on plonge, expiration. On inspire, demi-remontée. Expiration, plank, chaturanga, let it go. Upward or baby cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Les deux pieds ensemble, même chose, l'autre côté. Now left leg rises. High lunge, step it through. Breathe in, rise with the arms. Twist over to the left, exhale. Inhale, back to center. Maintenant, à droite. Beautiful. Breathe in, rise. And all one exhale, hands come down, step back. This could be a three-legged chaturanga if you'd like. Upward dog. And downward dog. Take a deep breath in and out. Here we're going to drop down onto our knees. Keeping our hips just above the knees, we're going to find melting heart pose. So if you've noticed yet, we're actually doing a lot of work on the back today. So we're strengthening the spine, your spinal cord or your spinal column. I'm out of breath. Your spinal cord, your spinal column is a huge area of support in the body. So support being what we're focusing on today, we're gonna open up a lot of the back, a lot of the shoulders. So you're walking your hands forward while keeping your hips right over your knees. Your knees are about hips width distance. And as you slowly start to lower down, notice the way that your sits bones want to naturally separate from one another. If you're having problems bringing the chin, nose, or forehead to the mat, you can just completely listen to the body, number one, but allow for that float to happen. If it's uncomfortable, drop down the elbows. And your chin does not have to come to the floor just yet, but we want to think of creating that opening. Take two more. Slowly press into all 10 fingers, rise up with the torso, walk your hands nice and slow back to you, and we're in our tabletop pose. Take a breath in. Curl your toes, hips up high, downward dog, exhale. Come high to your toes, bend your knees, step, walk, or float, les pieds vers les poignets, demi-remonté, le dos est plat, 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 flat back. Et on plonge, expiration. Inhale, arms to rise, interlace the fingers, release the index, cross the thumbs, and drop over to your right side. Good, equally press both feet into the floor. Feel the sides of the body create space and expand. We're thinking more so about bringing our fingertips up and to the side, not just to the side, right? We want to keep that opening in the heart. Prochaine inspiration, on retourne au milieu, come back to center. And opposite side, exhale. Last one. Inhale brings us back up. And exhale, hands come to heart center. Take a deep breath in. Actually, I'm gonna go here and out. So we're gonna take a really nice big step back to the back of our mat with our left foot. Left foot will be 90 degrees. We're gonna find our way into our warrior two pose. So the toes are facing over to the side, front toes are facing forward, right knee is right above the ankle. Good. We're going to reach forward, breathe in, exhale, and come back. Two more. In, forward, back out. One more time, forward, and back. This time, we're going to flip the front palm, breathe in. Exhale, dance out your warrior. Breathe in, bring your elbow to your thigh, reach your left arm forward, and then helicopter your hands. Exhale, dance it out. Good, two more times. Bring the elbow, reach, and back. Last one. This time we're going to come back to our elbow onto the thigh and we're going to reach. Option is to stay here or to bring the arm flush to the inside of your leg. Third option is to get really nice and jazzy with it and we're reaching forward, pretending we have a ball in between our hands. I'm gonna stay here for now. We're gonna take two more. And one. Lift and come all the way back to your warrior two. Straight front leg, give that quad a little bit of a break. Reach forward and exhale, find your triangle pose. So here you're finding all of that extension with the side body. You're pressing your left hip up to the sky and you're reaching, 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 reaching. Trying not to lock that front knee, take two. Come all the way back up and hands to the hips. Exhale. Turn your right foot forward. So now we're ready for a wide-legged forward fold. Breathe in, squeeze the shoulders, lift the heart. Exhale, hinge at the hips, fold forward. You can let your hands come down onto the floor. You can grab for your ankles, whichever feels best. Take three here. Last one. Whatever it is you're holding on to, let that go. Bring your hands below your face, finding a halfway lift. Breathe in and turning over towards your right foot so you're facing the front of the mat again. Turning onto your back toes, and we are in our active low lunge. Fait que les deux mains sont à l'intérieur de nos pieds droits. Notice if you can activate your back leg just a little bit more, and notice if you could send your left hip towards the front of the mat. Sending your right hip back, take two more. On this second exhale, passive low lunge, drop that back leg. I encourage you to find a place that feels best for you here. We're gonna hold this for about four breaths. So you can remain on your hands. You can maybe come down onto one forearm if you're working towards it. Si c'est possible, si c'est accessible. Mais toujours, on pense de support. What is supporting your body, your breath, and your practice? A lot of the times we think that the first variation is a weakness, that we should be able to delve deeper. It could not be further from the truth. The first variation, if this has the most support for you, that you can take really invigorating, beautiful, energizing breaths, then by all means, that's the right place for you to be. Last one. If you came all the way down onto your forearms, slowly make your way up back onto your hands. Fait qu'on revient sur les mains. In, we're gonna heel toe the foot in between the hands. Fait que le pied droit entre les deux mains maintenant. Curl the toes, lift up the hips. Both, yes, legs come up. Bend into the back knee and spring yourself forward. You might really feel your hip here. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold. Take a moment here in your fold. Notice if one leg feels a little bit longer than the other. Let's flush it out with a flow. Slowly roll up to rise. Circle your arms up with you. Les mains devant le cœur. On expire. Et on trouve notre vinyasa. Let's flow it out. Breathe in. Arms up. Circle them up to rise. Your choice, you could swan dive or prayer fold forward, c'est à vous. Soit en prière ou on ouvre les bras, on inspire, demi-remontée. So you're looking forward towards the top of your mat. Step or hop, your choice. If you want to make it a little bit more active, send those legs back. Keep your elbows glued, chaturanga. I want to look at everyone. Breathe in, come up. And hips up high, exhale. Downward facing dog, take a breath in. Et on ouvre la bouche, puis on expire. Good. We're gonna find our warrior two. So big toes to touch, left leg rises. Look forward, step the foot through, turn the back toes 90 degrees, windmill your arms up and over. Take a moment to set up your warrior two. Make sure everything is really nice and aligned. I say this in class a lot. Remember, you could choose hand on the belly and the back to really make sure that everything is one nice kind of flush line. We're just engaging the body a little bit more, the abdominals and the sides, even the quad by doing this. So come forward just a bit. Breathe out and come back. Obliques are bringing us forward. And back, une dernière fois. Keep that bend in the knee the whole time. Forward and back. Come back to center, breathe in, flip the front palm. Exhale and dance it out. Le cou vient sur la cuisse, on inspire. Et on danse, on expire. Dance your warrior out. Two more, in. Up and out. Last one. And back here, breathe in. This is that time to check out your legs, check out your body. Make sure that you're not using the thigh to rest your torso on. This is engaged, this is lifted. Quad is firing up. Take one more. Lengthen the front leg, come back to center, and exhale into your triangle. Again, if you notice here, I'm locking my leg. I want to keep somewhat of a teeny tiny bend so that it won't require me to pop my knee out when I want to rise. Take one more. Maybe you're challenging yourself today by looking up towards the sky. Maybe you're just looking straight ahead. Maybe you're looking down. Breathe in, back to your warrior two, sorry, your triangle legs. Hands to your hips, turning onto the left heel. Squeeze the shoulders, breathe in. Exhale again and fold. This is a passive moment. If you're looking to make it really, really deep, you can walk your hands in between your legs. So here your palms would be facing down, fingertips away from you, and you'd be walking through the legs. If you're looking for more extension in the spine, then you can walk the arms forward. Otherwise, grabbing for the ankles, the big toes, whatever feels best here. Last one. Beautiful. Bring your hands back just below your face. On inspire pour un demi-remonté ici. Puis on marche les mains vers le pied gauche. So you're turning onto your left foot. Et on reste active. Fait que la jambe en arrière reste dans l'air. Les deux mains à l'intérieur, toujours de nos pieds gauche. Can you make that back leg a little bit more active? Encore, on revient toujours à notre intention aujourd'hui de support. It is very, very possible that one side of the body differs from the other. So this is an opportunity to check in with this hip. On your next exhale, drop that back knee. Ça devient passif. Et encore, on peut rester sur les mains. On peut descendre sur un ou les deux bras. Making sure that all four corners of your left foot do remain in contact, though, with the mat. Take two more here. Come back onto your hands slowly if you're not there already. Heel, toe, the foot in between your hands. Pied gauche entre les deux mains. Curl your back toes, lift up the hips, bend into the back knee and spring forward. Halfway lift. Et encore, on plonge, puis on reste ici pour une respiration. Notice your legs. Do they feel even? Does one side feel a little bit more lengthier than the other? Take one more. Press into the feet, inhale, slowly roll up to rise. Circle your arms with you as you come to the top, breathe in. And exhale, hands to heart center. On prend l'inspiration. Et on expire. Good, so for balancing today, we're gonna keep it really nice and simple. Tree to toppling tree, we'll do both sides, flush it out with some flows, and then we'll make our way down. Fait qu'on commence toujours avec les mains sur les hanches. You can see exactly where it is that you are on your mat, eye face forward, because it's a lot more helpful. So we're going to place all the weight. Let's start. On va ouvrir la jambe droite. So you're going to stay onto your left leg, and we're going to open up the right side. Yeah. Fait qu'on peut garder toujours les orteils sur le tapis. Sinon, le pied entre la cheville et le genou. So, foot, it either rests on the floor, in between the ankle and the knee, or we lift it up, high to the thigh. On oublie toujours le genou. On trouve de la longueur dans la jambe gauche. So, left leg is really nice and proud. You can always change up the position of your hands if you'd like. Les deux mains peuvent rester en prière, les bras sur nos côtés. Whatever it is, notice this energy right here. The energy of the foot into the thigh and the thigh into the foot. On pousse le pied dans la jambe, puis la jambe dans le pied. Et on garde tout le support de nos corps dans la jambe gauche. Take one more here. Ici, très lentement, le genou gauche au milieu, guide your right knee to center, and then kick your leg out. Sweep the leg back, don't let it contact the floor. If you need to though, it's okay. If you need to find balance, flexion dans le pied en arrière. Flex, 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 flex that right foot, and maybe you fly your arms out to the sides. On prend deux. Engage your standing leg, last one. Sweep the leg up with you like you did when you brought it back. Breathe in all the way up. Et on plonge, drop the foot, exhale, fold. Flush it out with a vinyasa, breathe in. Halfway lift. Exhale to your plank and chaturanga. Upward dog or baby cobra, inhale. And exhale, down dog. On inspire. Et on expire. Come high to the toes, bend the knees. Step walk or float to your hands. Halfway lift. And fold. Rise. Hands to heart center. La même chose, l'autre côté. Hands onto your hips. Take a moment if you need to shake out that ankle, move everything around. And when you're ready, all the weight into your right foot, open up your left leg. Et on trouve le placement. 100% c'est correct si le placement est différent que l'autre côté. Notice where you can help your supporting leg. If the upper body is a little bit loosey-goosey, you're asking the upper leg to do a lot more work. Where can you help the points of support? Fait qu'ici, on peut toujours aider notre pratique avec nos pensées. If your thoughts are all over the place, then that does not support your practice. If your body is all over the place, it does not support your other parts of your body, right? So noticing how one area feeds the next, feeds the next, and feeds the next. Tranquillement, genou gauche au milieu. Kick the leg out and sweep it behind you. It's okay if your toe needs to touch the mat to keep your balance. Une ligne de vos couronnes jusqu'aux vos talons. You're creating one long line. You could be here and this could be a perfectly acceptable toppling tree. If you lift the leg, the torso follows. On your next inhale, sweep the leg up with you, arms come up. Et on plonge, expiration. Demi-remontée, halfway lift. Exhale, plank and hold. Breathe in, lift your right leg. Exhale, connect knee to elbow. Extend it back, keep your plank. And again, exhale, knee to elbow. One more time, extend and connect. Extend plank pose. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra or upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Take a breath in. Plank pose, exhale. L'autre côté, jambe gauche, on inspire. Engage, exhale, connect. Engage just sends the leg back. Exhale brings it forward and connects. One last time, back and connect. Position de planche, on inspire. Chaturanga, exhale. Baby cobra or upward dog. All one, exhale. Downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. Child's pose, exhale. Les genoux à une distance de nos tapis, les orteils ensemble. Sit yourself back. Soupirez. Take three here. Les mains juste sur chaque côté de vos visages. Hands are framing your face. Roll yourself up nice and slowly. And sit on one side. Swing your legs forward. I'm going to face here. So we're going to keep our right leg into the body. And our left leg is extended. Fait que, pied droit. Good, yes. Alrighty. Ici, main droite en arrière, right hand comes behind you. Inhale to lift up the left arm. On inspire, fait qu'on commence notre twist ici. This is where you start your twist. You have two options, elbow to the outside of your leg so that you create the stop sign and you twist, or hug the leg. Et toujours beaucoup de longueur sur le dos. All right. So if you notice here, even though I'm hugging my leg, I'm not rounding. J'utilise la main en arrière pour noter la longueur. Notice your extension and your flexion in your left foot. Avec chaque expiration, peut-être on twist un peu plus profondément. So noticing that your gaze dictates the twist. Taking two. Release the contact of your right leg. Counter twist. Come back to center. Extend your legs. Lift the fleshy parts away from your sits bones. Breathe in, reach your arms up. Flexion dans les deux pieds toujours. Un petit peu de souplesse dans les genoux. Expiration, on plonge. This is really passive. I want you to notice the way that the backs of your knees feel and also the sides of the body. Is there any difference? Does one side feel like it's able to extend a little bit further than the other? Last one. If you're holding on to anything, let it go. Les mains, les bras glissent. Let your arms or your hands slide by your legs as you roll up. And we're going to switch sides. So now we bring the left leg into the body. Flexion dans le pied droit. Left arm comes behind us. Breathe in, set up. Exhale and connect. So I'm gonna show the opposite variation here than I did on the other side. Please notice if your front foot can use a little bit more flexion. The hand at the back of you is only meant for balance. La main en arrière, c'est pour la balance et pour la longueur. So your back arm is supporting you. With this twist, you may need to lengthen your breaths so that they don't shorten. Take the time to breathe slower, but still a lot deeper. Maybe you start to gaze towards your back shoulder, maybe allowing the twist to get a little bit deeper. Last one. When you're ready, slowly release that contact. Counter twist. Come back to center, breathe in, extend the legs. And again, exhale, fold.
Très, très, très passif avec le front, avec la tête, mais toujours beaucoup d'espace entre les oreilles et les épaules.
Excuse me.
Encore les bras, les mains sur nos côtés, puis on glisse, slide your way up.
Breathe in. Plant your hands down, bend into your knees, plant your feet down. And if you want, you can make this a little roll to massage the spine as you come down and then rock side to side.
On va placer le pied gauche sur le tapis, extension dans la jambe droite.
And then connect the foot to the knee. We're finding our figure four, thread the needle.
Je m'excuse.
Framing the sides of your thigh with your hands, bring your knee in. And just enjoy that opening in the hip.
On peut placer les mains en arrière ou juste en dessous de nos genoux.
Excuse me. Good. Really nice. Avec chaque expiration, ça relâche le ventre, puis ça nous donne l'espace de tirer la jambe.
You can release the hands from your leg, drop the foot down, unhook the opposite foot, windshield wiper the leg.
Désolée, j'ai un peu de la misère de rester sur le dos à cause de l'asthme. So I'm gonna stay here. Good. Quand vous êtes prête, on change de côté. So this time the left leg is going to rise. I'll show us the seated variation. Same thing. Except you approach the body to the leg. Whereas the laying down variation brings the leg to the body. Last two.
And releasing the hands from the leg, dropping the foot down first, unhook the foot, and a nice windshield wiper with the legs. Je vous invite ici de trouver une position qui vous convient le mieux.
Whatever pose makes you feel really, really good from your back.
ideally. So happy baby, shoulder stand. Recline butterfly. Maybe it's just giving yourself a hug. Let's take two more here. Depending on where it is that you are, if you need to take a little bit more caution to make your way back down slowly, everybody meeting with the knees into the chest. Give yourself a really nice squeeze. Arms are around the legs. Peut-être le front vient un peu plus proche de vos genoux. On inspire tout ensemble. And as you exhale, release out the mouth and arms and legs onto the floor. Final Shavasana. This is that last little bit of support that you're asking from your practice today. This pose is the most important of the entire practice because it allows for every single breath, every single movement, and every single pose to be understood and integrated into the body. Je peux vous dire, comme prof, il y a beaucoup de personnes quand on était dans les cours en personne. Mais il y a beaucoup de gens qui partent les cours pendant le Shavasana. A lot of people leave at this point. You'd be surprised. And don't get me wrong, sometimes I understand people have a tight schedule. But a lot of times, people choose to leave because the calmness and the stillness that comes with Shavasana is a little terrifying. Et je comprends complètement parce que d'être avec nous-mêmes, essayer de trouver le silence dans nos têtes, c'est pas toujours facile, et quand c'est pas facile, on trouve des jugements. You judge yourself if you can't calm the mind. And sometimes just even observing the thoughts are a little bit much. But what we don't realize is that we take away the gift of the body understanding the movements that we just did. This is part of your recovery. This is part of your body's understanding of the practice of yoga. Et peut-être c'est les seuls moments dans vos journées que il y a pas d'ordinateur, il y a pas de téléphone, il y a pas de conversation. You're not falling asleep, you're not in front of a TV. You're resting, but consciously and with intention. Allow yourself to take four more full cycles of breath here. Keeping your eyes closed, gardez les yeux fermés. Puis on commence de bouger les doigts, les orteils. Bring some life back into your body super slowly by engaging the fingers and the toes. On trouve un étirement du corps complet, full body stretch like we did at the beginning of class. Reach back, point forward. Encore avec les yeux fermés, keep the eyes closed, roll on to your side. Take a breath here. Et quand vous êtes prête, on utilise la main et on pousse pour lever le torse. Lift up your torso. Slowly to rise. Easy seat. Something simple for the body. Shoulders relaxed, eyes are closed, and we take our three closing breaths together, in through the nose and out. Two more. Last one. You can bring your hands to your heart or keep your hands on your knees, completely up to you.
Ici, toujours, c'est notre petit moment pour remercier nos corps, nos respirations, notre pratique, puis notre énergie.
It is so important to take this moment of gratitude to thank ourselves and thank all of the supporting elements of the last 60 minutes. Breath, body, practice, energy, and of course, each other. C'est moi qui vous remercie comme toujours. Thank you for giving me the honor to guide you this evening or whenever it is that you're tuning in. I want to thank you for your continued energetic support for not only myself, but for InnoCer. We want to thank you for being present and for finding the energy to step onto your mat every time you do. On vous apprécie infiniment. Merci, merci, merci. Thank you. As always, 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 I wish each and every one of you to choose courage over comfort. Have a wonderful evening, everyone. Namaste. Thank you, y'all. Thank you, everyone.